In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
In the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Holy Spirit, please help me, guide me, give me grace, and make all the words your words, so that they touch everybody and bring them in your love. Amen. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name I pray, please bless me, give me grace to proclaim your word. Amen. Holy Spirit, whoever watches this video, inspire them, touch them, get all their works done, so that they proclaim your good news and pass the message to everybody they know. Amen. Holy Spirit, whoever is watching the video anytime in their life, inspire them, touch them to pass it to many people of their contacts, and get all their works done, so that they live a joyful life. Amen. These days we were talking about some sayings. Today is the 16th of October 2020, sweet 16. So people are saying like this way, there is nothing sweet in any number, only Jesus is sweet. If there is no Jesus, everything is sour and salty in your life. It will not taste anything better or anything good. Everything will go in the opposite direction. Because first of all, you are going opposite God. That means naturally by default, for every action, there is a opposite and equal reaction. So equal reaction which you are going against God means the devil will give you equal reaction for that. If you do bad, you get bad. If you do good, you get good. Take this message today about sweet 16. Let's see what Holy Spirit is talking to us today. And keep it in your mind that you have learnt it and came to know on this day, the people called the sweetest day, 16. And they make a big show on their birthday and all when they turn 16. There are many different issues in our life where we are going against God. This is like numerology, we can say. We are worshipping this, the numbers, the days. Some they are say sad days. Friday is a day of suffering because Jesus was on his passion. So many people are given wrong notions, and as per the day they were living that particular day in their life, as per the sayings are there. So this is all false, and this is nothing of God, and nothing good will come if people believe in this, because we have to only believe what Jesus told us to do. That is very important. We must not add anything in the Bible, then it becomes the corrupted version which you are writing of your own. That is not from the God. So don't make anything addition, and don't believe in anything wrong by yourself, thinking that the explanation is like this. No. Once you come into the grace and love of God, you will definitely come to know what wrong was you was doing for so many years, like me. What Jesus said when Jesus came to the apostles, Jesus nicely said in clear words, there is no parable, there is no equation, no puzzle to solve, nothing was there to solve, nothing was hidden. But Jesus said in very clear words, Jesus said to them, Mark 16:15. See, here also the Mark 16 is come. Mark 16 and verse 15. Jesus said to them, go into the world and preach the gospel to all creation. To all creation. Means there is no religion in this. But I am telling you, we will only stick to the Catholic community. Because we are the largest in the world. And if we become all godly, if this largest population become full of grace, then you can do what God can make out of this world. This world will become a paradise, because we are the largest, highest population in the world, the Roman Catholic. So better be careful not to believe in the wrong sayings and drag away with that, spoiling the name of God, because we are judged by our actions. It is also written in the Bible. People are judging us, people are looking at us, and they are saying there is nothing good in us, in Catholics. Even their life is like what they are thinking, same like their life they are thinking, our life is also like that. There is nothing good in our life. This is the judgment other people are making on the Catholics at the moment. That is why I have to come out and to say in the open directly what is happening. I don't want to cover anything. I will talk straight. I don't want to keep anything hidden from you all. And once you die and you go to hell, that time you will say Tiago was preaching nicely, but he did not tell openly that we were doing wrong or we were into sin. If Tiago would have told us clearly what we were doing, that time we would have changed our life, and we would have gone to heaven to enjoy God's presence and to live a joyful life forever and ever. But now we are burning in hell like this, people will say. So I don't want anybody to be kept in the dark. Enough is enough. Somebody has to come out in open and say that it is wrong. Like Jesus was going in the open. Jesus went for 3.5 years telling, opening the eyes of people, turning the table, and driving away all the business makers in the temple. Jesus was talking clearly, very clear words are there, and same words I am using. The death, you will die soon, the death and the destruction, everything I am saying clearly what is there in the Bible. I don't want to hide and don't want to skip those scriptures and only tell you the parables and tell you bedtime stories like and finish it off. No. That is all useless, because we used to listen and learn this for years, and everything is there in our mind. There is no need to teach and preach anything. It is already there in our head. It is there in our heart. That is called faith. And even we can speak and talk about it. We can say these scriptures, and we can even explain the parables to others as well, like prodigal son. The son went, took his share, and he went and he finished everything, he spoiled, and he came back, and God took, father took him back. Father means what? Our heavenly father. So like this, we know so many parables. See, within a few seconds, I finish one parable. So like this, if I teach you the same parables, what is the use? You will listen, you will sleep after that, or you will go to work and finish, your day is over. The same old ways and the same old sins and same old bad habits we will live. If you only read the Bible, if I only teach the Bible, preach the Bible. We must make it use. We must put it in use. We must make a good use of it, correct use of it. Then only we will profit of make profit of it. If we don't use it, then we will be in great loss on the earth. We will not get any benefits from God, because we are blocking our own way. So Jesus is saying, go into the world and preach the gospel to all the creation. So we will not preach now, we will only put it in use at this point of time, unless and until all Catholics don't start to do miracles and wonders in the world. We will only tell the Catholics how to use the Bible and how to make the scriptures work in their daily life. I told you, even if you get a cold, you tell the cold to die from the root, all the infection and the whatever is there of the cold allergy. If you have dust allergy or the cold allergy or the breeze, the wind allergy, you tell all the allergy to die from the root, like Jesus cursed the fig tree. And it should die, it should obey you. That is for sure. Because Jesus told the wind to stop and the sea was calm. Every word is having a power. Just a few seconds, Jesus spoke few words. Be calm, and the sea was calm. You don't have to read the whole Bible. Only quote the scripture which is there in the Bible. That is having the power. And you tell that whatever blocking you, whatever problem is there, sickness is there, poverty is there, you tell them to die from the root. in the name of Jesus. Like Jesus cursed the fig tree and the fig tree died from the root. And that should fall, and you must get a good job, and your finances will grow. You will not only build one house, like our community is only building one house and buying one plot and buying one car. Finish, their life is over. If you come to God, you will build so many things. Not just one house and not one property and not just one car. And that is also when you are sick. When you fall sick, that also Satan is taking it away. You have to sell everything for your sickness. I am telling you this day in and out. Whatever you have earned, thinking that it is from your power, everything is Satan is taking back. Everything is going in water. Like you flush in the toilet, it will go to the doctors for the medicine and some bad vices and all not stuff, it will go back and you will be a beggar in the end of the day. That is for sure. If you don't come to the word, then you will be beggar at the end of the day, because you see our ancestors, they were all beggars. They were living in the plots which the other people were owning. Have a look on our ancestors. So they made a mistake. Nobody was there to tell them. We know, and I am come out to tell. That is why I am telling you. Tell everybody. Let's become big and posh, and we will proclaim the word to everybody. God will bless us abundantly. Go in the dictionary and see the meaning of this abundantly. There will be nothing less, nothing lacking in our life at all. Health will not fall, and this money will not go. We won't become bankrupt. Nothing. Just I have given you 5 points in my description on every video, on every upload. I am putting it now. Auto, I have made it auto description. So whenever I load a video and it is seen by anybody, you can see it. Yesterday I told you. So be careful. Go through that. Don't waste your time. I am telling you every time, you don't know what the Satan is planning you for the next minute. That is why we have to be very careful. And once we come into the word, we must go on blessing. Don't keep it to you. Like a candle, Jesus has given a nice example of a candle. If it does not profit you, if it does not give you light, and what is the use of that candle? Lighting the candle and finishing it off. In a closed room without making good use, and you are living in the dark, it is not helping. That candle is not helping anybody. So this light of the candle must reach and make a good use of it, and it has to be helpful for others, so that they will also get profit, and they will also become more candles in their life, and they will also go and burn themselves and give light to others. So this we are like candles. We have to give light for others, those who are still in the dark, even the Catholics who are in the dark. Though we know so many scriptures, our faith is very high, only we have to use it. But I told you, live the sinful life, forgive everybody, love everybody unconditionally, give 10% to the God, and whatever government needs, give it. Don't cheat anybody. Give whatever is there. The more you give, the more money you get. I am telling you every time. The more money you give out, the 100% you will get. So you are paying for authorities this and that. Even that government is multiplying. Whatever you give, that is also a help, I told you. Paying the authorities is also a help for all other people who are not so good. Because the old people, government is giving money, the pensioners, government is giving money. So all this money is helping for the poor, and government will definitely bless that money also. Our 10% will government, God will bless by 100, multiply by 100. And whatever we are paying, the bills and all, that will also government, God will multiply by 100. So much benefit will come to us. So don't worry, don't think that you will get poor. On the other hand, you will get very rich. So Catholics, this is the thing, we must bless everybody. Once we get a blessing, we must go and tell everybody that God has given me this. God has done this. So many years I was living a good life. I never had a problem with money, even though I was bad. God was providing me. Even though I was sick, God brought me out from the sickness. Even I met with an accident, or was supposed to met with an accident and die on the spot. But God has saved me even from that. Our God is so good, even though I was so bad. So like this, we must tell people that God is good all the time. But it is only our sin, our wickedness, that only is making a problem, and we are bringing sickness on ourselves, and we die soon. And we die a dog of dog like a mad dog, and die the death of, like a mad dog. So be careful, wake up and stand up. Like the sayings is saying, fight for your right. If we fight with these scriptures, all the world will become good. Catholics will start getting manifestation, getting blessed in all the ways. Satan will flee away. Not only he will run, he will flee. When we fight with these scriptures, when we fight for the right, what God has given us, and the Satan is trying to cheat and take it away from us, we must fight with the scriptures to the Satan. And the Satan will run, he will flee, and he does not come back also. So this is the power, the authority God has given to us. It is very simple and easy to use, and everybody can use it. Even a child can use it. If the child is saying Jesus, then that is also a big prayer. When the child is young, 3 years, and when the child is trying to talk, first word must be Jesus. And that will benefit the child and will keep the child happy, because there is power in the name of Jesus. The Satan flee when you say Jesus. So there is power in the name of Jesus. So if you have time, say Jesus, and whatever the prayers you want to pray, say like this: in the name of Jesus, Heavenly Father, I pray to you to bless my day today, and to help me to get all my work done easily, without any problem. Please remove all the blocks in the name of Jesus. I pray to you, Heavenly Father. Amen. Like these simple prayers, we must pray it correctly. Always ask to God the Father in the name of Jesus Christ. Only this you must do. And keep in mind that you say it every time you pray, whenever you do even little prayer for a family or for anybody, loved ones, or even lost loved ones, if they are not in Jesus Christ, if they are not in the glory, if they are still into sin and hatred and anger, you are pray to God, Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, to give them grace, to show the mercy on them, and to help them, to convict them what they are the wrongs they are doing, and to bring them in the word of God, in God's word, in Jesus Christ's love, to serve others. So like this, we must help each and everybody, each and every family members of us. So that will make our bond with Jesus strong. The more family members are coming together, it will bring a unity, and it will show even to the others that our family is a holy family, like the family of Mother Mary. This always we must take care of. So whatever families are lost, they are also not strangers. They are also children of God. So don't consider them as enemies, our neighbors who are bad. Don't take them as enemies. We know they are wrong, but we can at least pray whenever we are free. No need to. I told you, don't say Our Father and Hail Mary after every prayer. Forget about it. Only ask to Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, please help my neighbors, convict them what wrong they are doing. Show them the wrong they are doing, so that they can believe and walk like Jesus. Like this, simply you pray. Don't say 1 hour, Father, 3 Hail Mary, God, please help them. No, how God will help them? You must ask in the name of Jesus. Don't only say, Jesus, do this. No, you must ask Heavenly Father in the name of Jesus. This you must do. I told you, younger, small children who cannot pray, they can say Jesus at least, because there is power in the name of Jesus. And God knows they cannot pray much, but there is power in the name of Jesus. God will help them in that way because they cannot make long prayers because they are young. They are just learning to talk. But devil will flee from them. They will not fall sick. Like we used to fall sick, our parents used to run to the doctors. They had so much problem with the sickness of us and for other. Even all the family, these parents have the problem when the child is young, just born for a couple of years, 1-2 years, there are normal sicknesses which the child is having. This is all from the devil. This is not from God. God is only giving good children. God is giving. So this is not from God. So be very careful not to do wrong prayers. And then don't blame God. Don't say God is dead. God is not there. We don't believe in God. We are this and we are that. Don't say that. You are praying wrong and you are complaining. You are into ignorance. Though you have brain, God has given you brain. You studied so much and you are on so much, such a big position in the job. And still you are saying God cannot hear your prayer. God is not hearing your prayer. How come? Why you don't know only this? You raised a family, you have kids, so many people, you have a house you built, everything you built. But only when you come to God, you become a fool. You are making a fool out of yourself. So don't become a fool. Don't spoil your life. Don't die like a dog. Live like Jesus. We will stop here today. We will continue tomorrow. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Please bless us.
Please bless us.
With good health.
With good health.
Keep us free from COVID.
Keep us free from COVID.
Keep us free from cold and sneezing.
Keep us free from cold and sneezing.
Give us good strength.
Give us a good strength.
Keep all our organs healthy.
Keep all our organs healthy.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus.
Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus.
Please bless Jyoti and family.
Please bless Jyoti and family.
Fill them with wisdom, knowledge and faith.
Them with wisdom, knowledge and faith.
Give increment and promotion.
Give increment and promotion.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Bless Navita and family.
Bless Navita and family.
Give them increment and promotion. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Please bless Vanya and Leah.
Please bless Vanya and Leah.
Euphemia and Aruna.
Euphemia and Aruna.
With all good things.
With all good things.
With wisdom, knowledge and faith.
Wisdom, knowledge and faith.
Amen. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray. Bless Bosco and family. Bless Bosco and family.
Bosco and family.
Keep their job safe.
Keep the job safe.
Give them increment and promotion.
Give them increment and promotion.
Amen. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Please bless Elita and Jesse.
Please bless Elita and Jesse.
Violeta and Trevor.
Violeta and Trevor.
With a good job. close to the house.
Close to the house.
High salary.
Close to the house. High salary.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. In Jesus' name we pray.
Bless Mural, Peter and Jaden.
Bless Mural, Peter and Jaden.
Make theirs a holy family.
Make their holy family.
And keep the job safe. Amen.
Keep their job. Amen.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Bless Alex, Jamily, and Lorraine. Bring them together. Fill them with wisdom, knowledge, and faith. Cancel all the bad things. Amen. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Fathers, in Jesus' name we pray.
Bless Mackley and parents.
Bless Mackley and parents.
With wisdom, knowledge, and faith.
Wisdom, knowledge, and faith.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Bless Andrew with increment.
Bless Andrew with increment.
And increase his post.
And increase his post.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Father, in Jesus' name we
pray. Bless Zinia and Alfio.
Bless Zinia and Alfio.
With the gift of child.
Gift of child.
Amen.
Amen.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name we pray.
Bless William and Connie.
Bless the William and Connie.
Make all their dreams come true.
Dreams come true.
Fill them with wisdom, knowledge, and faith.
Fill them with wisdom, knowledge, and faith.
Cancel all the bad things.
Cancel all the bad things.
Amen.
Amen.